people have heard of. What's the name of? You can find it on any map. What's the name of? Folks are flocking to it from all over. What's the name of it? Beaumont.
Have I done the right thing? arrived from Chicago. Matthew McCormick and her son. Ron, is it?
Ren.
Speak up, boy. Let the Lord hear your voice.
Ren.
Ren.
Ren McCormick.
Ren. Interesting name. Is it short for something?
Nope.
There's rumors going round about the new kid, and everybody's talking till they're blue.
Chapter 1. Oh my god, did I interrupt your weekly poetry club meeting?
Very funny. So, who's this new guy, Turk?
Who? Oh, him. Oh, he's our new classmate. A Chicago transplant with all the charm and sophistication that comes from living in a bustling metropolis.
Should I be jealous?
I'm counting on it.
Hey, Chris, just what do you think you're doing with the preacher's daughter?
Anything I want?
Oh, yeah? What does she get out of it?
Everything she needs.
Like you know.
Sure do like those bad boys, don't you?
Oh, she knows the size of that, it's crazy. Yeah.
Now, why would I want to do something like that?
I'm wondering.
Ariel?
Evening, Raptor.
I went to the burger class. Your friend suggested you might be here.
Yeah, we were just on our way there.
Your mother thought she might be cold.
Check it out. That's how we pass.
That's not what it looked like.
That, oh, those are stuff we used to
have. Oh, don't!
Don't what? You mean this?
Oh, Lord.
Mr. McCormick! There's no dancing allowed here.
Oh.
Listen to the woman.
My bad. School property. Not supposed to have any fun.
That sort of remarks may pass for wit in Chicago, but here we speak simply. So let me make this as clear as I possibly can. There is no dancing of any kind allowed anywhere within the town limits of Beaumont.
But don't you know that?
Enter!
She's kidding, right, guys? She's serious? Oh, I get it. Joke's on the new kid. Ha ha.
Mr. Hewitt, would you inform your friend?
It's against the law.
Dancing? Get out.
Shut up. Mrs. Clark, ma'am, Grant is really sorry. He was ignorant of our local laws. And I will be sure to inform him of his ignorance.
And I will see both you in my office after school. I'm sure we all have some place to be.
Oh my gosh, Lauren. The way you talk to Principal Clark, that's like the longest sentence you've ever made.
Chin up, Mr. McCormick. It's such a turn on watching you guys fly in the face of authority, isn't it, Winnie Jo? Uh-huh.
Is she serious?
Serious as a heart attack.
Dancing is against the law?
Has been for 5 years, ever since the accident.
What accident?
The Bhutani Bridge accident!
You've never heard of the Bhutani Bridge accident?
If I had, would I be doing this?
Well, ladies, should I take this one?
Please, be my guest.
Well, there are these four kids y'all grew up with, and they were heading back to the big dance over in Baylor County. Now, maybe it was the rain that night, maybe they were being a little wild, but somehow they lost control of the car. It skidded across the bridge, crashed into the railing, and fell 35 feet to the Bhutani River.
Did anyone survive? Oh, gosh.
Yeah, and when the police came out with the autopsy report, it claimed there was alcohol and marijuana in their blood. Well, everyone in this town went nuts.
And that's when Reverend Moore got so righteous he started blaming anything and everything. Liquor, drugs, rock and roll.
And dancing?
You got it.
He convinced the town council of all his sin, and like that, they passed this law.
Wait, Reverend Moore had that kind of power?
Reverend Moore?
He is the power. He is the law.
How can you stand to live like this?
Practice. Years of practice.
It's not like in Chicago. It must be so cool to live in a city where you can walk down the street and get mugged by people you don't even know.
Yeah, I miss that. I thought the town hall would be perfect. Like one big happy family.
Let me tell you about that thing. There's tongues wagging every time you make a move.
There's fingers pointing every time you turn around. There's head shaking the minute you cross the line. And there's eyes everywhere.
Careful how you
you just slammed into your fist?
What? Oh,
that's enough! My boys
are
on the difference to a wrestling match and a street fight.
Really, Coach? Normally, a wrestling match is one-on-one.
That is enough out of you. This is the third time in as many weeks you've been dragged into my office. I'm suspending you from the wrestling team. Indefinitely.
About Ariel, where she is, what she's doing.
You can't expect her to sit at home with us.
stop this conversation right here.
Conversation?
Bye.
I'm sorry, I seem to have walked in on one of your sermons.
Please, let's not say anything we might regret.
Well, that outfit makes you look like a lunch lady. It's easier to pick down.
You're always in for a fight, aren't you?
Mom said it's in my nature.
Well, tell me what you know about her.
Well, I know she's been kissed a lot.
And
she's on to you like hog on slop.
Get out of here.
Ariel likes trouble, and you've definitely proved to everybody in this town that you are T-R-U-B-L.
Come on, I was only teasing him.
Oh, that's more than teasing. Run from out of town, don't come to that door, curl your toes.
You want out of Beaumont, you, I bet you memorize my schedule. You told us you read just to escape to other worlds.
Exactly, because in books I get to meet guys who amaze me.
What about Ren?
What about him?
He's sort of smart.
He's kind of tall. And I think he's handsome.
Cute, maybe.
But can you really compete with Chuck Ransom, the rugged, dangerous, high school dropout / drug dealer who was recently evicted from a trailer park? I don't think so.
What's up with you and Rusty?
Beats me. I mean, I think she's good looking and all, but I never know what the heck she's talking about. She talks faster than any girl I ever met.
Because you make her excited.
Really?
Yeah, come on.
If only I could find a guy who would make the first move.
If only I could find a guy who, when he'd go to kiss me goodnight, he'd take the toothpick out of his mouth.
If only I could find a guy.
Where have all the good men gone? And where are all the gods?
Yeah.
Where's the streetwise Hercules to fight the rising odds?
Thank you.
I like you making a fool out of me.
Oh, if I would, you did such a great job of it yourself.
Shut up, Rusty. Will you be joining these ladies for dinner? Rex, say meet me an egg. What am I, talking to myself?
No, you're right. Calm down, honey.
Don't tell me to calm down. Don't ever tell me what to do. I'm the hottest party in this town. And these three dogs ought to show me on the porch. I know what they think of me. Let's go.
No.
Get in the truck.
No.
Excuse me?
I said no. What part of that don't you understand?
Oh, when the preacher's daughter says no, it just makes me hot. Say it again,
please. Just stop. Leave me alone.
I believe the lady said no. And I believe this is none of your business.
Ren, don't.
Who is this clown, Ariel?
Oh, I forgot. We haven't been formally introduced. Ren McCormick.
Get your hand out of my face and your face out of my sight.
Hey, Chuck, you looking for a fight?
Let's go. Come on.
Come on. Don't leave me. Come on. Miller. Not at all, man. Me and the guys are just discussing the comfort and safety of one of your valued customers.
Isn't that funny?
Hey, Cranston! Your pickup truck is parked in the handicapped parking space. Which is physical, not emotional disabilities.
You haven't seen the last of me, McCormick.
But I'll please take his butt.
We'll work with it. What's that your mama said? Before you make a fist, make sure it's your pocket.
Yes, ma'am.
And this is not your fight. Now, don't the rest of you have a curfew? And McCormick.
I know, ma'am. I'll turn in my stage.
Now, wait a minute. I will see you here after school tomorrow.
Really? So I'm not fired?
Nope, not yet. Come on over here. Oh,
yes, ma'am.
Thank you.
seems the only place my prayers fail me is at the bridge table.
Come on, just say hello to everybody. Hi, everyone. You all know Ren McCormick. Daddy, Ren.
Reverend. Coach Dunbar. Principal Clark.
Welcome, Ren. Hi, Mrs. Dunbar.
Mrs. Moore.
Hooker Knight. Cool.
Ariel, this whole time we thought you were upstairs in your room.
Doing your homework.
It's hard to impose a curfew on the young people of our congregation when I can't seem to keep one at home.
Well, what's that old saying? Oh, it's always the shoemaker's children that go barefoot.
Oh, Mom, would you look at time?
Boy, I can sure empty a room.
It's a rare talent.
I'm going to take that as a compliment.
I can assure you it wasn't meant that way.
Oh! Oh! I believe this is yours.
Ren, thanks for, you know.
Walking you home?
Yeah, that too.
Well, this was fun, don't you think, Reverend? I get nervous and I go crazy. I always end up putting my foot in my mouth.
Well, your mother said something about it, but I had no idea it was that bad.
Well, good night, Miss Moore.
Good night, Ren.
It's nothing, really.
Please, don't waste your breath or my time with another lame excuse, McCormick.
It's not an excuse. After Ben walked me home last night, some guys jumped in.
They all started wailing on him. There were like six of them.
Whoa, it was three guys.
Anybody you recognize?
Well, I didn't take names, if that's what you're asking.
McCormick, it seems when you're out causing trouble, trouble seems to find you anyways. Ariel, I suggest you stay away from this guy. I've been asked to keep my eye on
him. Oh, my daddy called you. Surprise, surprise.
And if you cooperate, it would make life for all of us much easier.
Gee, if my daddy made a phone call, would you get off of my back?
McCormick, that mouth of yours is probably the reason why your daddy ran off to begin with.
Count to ten, man. Mama says count to ten.
You'd be wise to listen to your friend. Ariel, back to practice. McCormick, give me 30.
You're kidding.
Oh, you're right. Maybe 50.
He's not faking, Coach. He's really hurting.
Oh, Dr. Willard, thank you for that diagnosis. You can give me 50 as well. Matter of fact, all of you can give me 50, courtesy of Mr. McCormick. Just do it. 1, 2, I can't hear you.
3, 4,
only 44.
6,
is he gone?
Yeah. Hey, Brent, thanks a lot.
Sorry, guys. This whole town is just so wound up.
Amen.
The guys have no place to blow off any steam.
You said it.
At least in Chicago, we have the clubs.
Hey, maybe we ought to take the clubs dancing.
Well, you're so...
What?
That's it.
What?
We'll throw a party. We'll throw a dancing off Goma right off this track.
You're laughing for a bite.
Bring it on.
Are you ready to take on Reverend Moore?
I'll take on anybody.
What about Sam Campbell?
I'm fighting him off. If there's one thing we're fighting for, it's freedom.
Mine, and I'm looking back, and it helps a man who
And now word comes to me that some young people in our community wish to change our laws to throw a dance. Let us remind ourselves that this is not a law against dancing, but rather a tribute to four young people that held the promise of Beaumont's brightest future.
All right. one cigarette. If I had both, I should never come home again.
Lord, come on. You're fine on a date with Rusty.
Is this a date? You asked me to go for a ride. You told Ariel to invite Rusty. It's almost like I'm on a date with you.
And you look so handsome.
Thanks. But you threw me in the back seat with a crazy woman who won't stop moving and talking.
She's just excited to be with you.
Well, that maybe. But the problem is,
yeah,
between you and me, I can't do it.
Oh, yeah. You can't do it.
No, sir.
That's okay, Willard. It's only the first date.
Right.
Even in Chicago, some people don't do it on the first date.
Really? I swear. Well. That makes me feel a lot better.
Great, let's go dance.
Dance? What the heck do you think I'm talking about?
Well, whenever you said you couldn't do it, you know, I thought you could do
what? That? Any idiot can do that. I'm talking about this. I can't dance.
What?
Did you hear that? Your boyfriend said you can't dance.
Come on, guys. Give him a break.
But it ain't natural. It's easy as learning to swim.
I can't swim.
Hey, fellas, what do you say we go push them in the pool?
Thank you.
here, Chuck.
Oh, Mrs. Moore.
Did I scare you?
No, not at all. Did you tell Ariel that?
Yeah, Chuck, I told her every time you called.
I guess she's pigeonholed.
Mm-hmm. She and the girls went up to Wendy Joseph's study.
Really? I was just there, and Wendy Joseph said she left hours ago with Rusty.
Oh.
Why? Why, who is it? Mr. Francis.
Evening, Reverend. I was just looking for Ariel.
It's a bit late, don't you think, Mr. Prince?
Yes, that's why I was surprised she wasn't here.
So am I. And next time, please remember, we have a front door for guests, Mr. Prince.
Yes, sir.
Where is she?
She told me she was going over to the girls' house to study. Don't bother calling, she's not there.
Did you know this?
No, I did not.
So how does it feel now, Vi, now that she's lying to you too?
I'm not going to say anything until I have an explanation from her.
I was worried enough when she was out with Chuck Cranston. Now she's out with this punk who's campaigning against me and the entire town council. How much longer can we keep defending her?
I'm not defending her. We're not on opposite sides here, are we? Or are we?
Where were you?
Oh, Rusty, Wendy, Joe, and me,
Don't even bother.
We know you weren't at Wendy Jones. I can't believe you're checking up on me. Honey, how do we know you're not sick or hurt?
I'm concerned for your well-being.
Then how come when I'm at home, you don't care about what I'm thinking or how I'm feeling, but the minute I walk out that door, wham, suddenly you're the concerned parent. Shaw, she doesn't mean that.
Stop taking her side.
I don't know what good that would do. She doesn't listen to me anymore than you listen to her. Shaw!
I've never hit anyone.
I know.
We're losing her, Vi. She's become willful and obstinate.
Like her father.
I am her spiritual guardian.
You used to be her friend.
I don't know what's happening. I don't know what to do anymore.
I think you do. Can you find it in your heart to forgive her? Can you stop and see there's part of her that's trying to obey, while part of her is dying to run away? Can't you hear what she's trying to say? Can you find it in your soul to accept her? If she stumbles on your holy path, do you have to up so high, they have to look down to see heaven. It's the one-on-one where you need a little work.
I thought at least you believed in me.
I never stopped. Does it ever cross your mind that I miss you? Is there any chance we'll find the joy that we shared at the start? Can you remember what you felt before that feeling fell apart? Can you find it in your heart? Have you lost my love somewhere far behind? Can you find it in
town council, so don't mumble. Now try that last part.
Members of the council, dancing is not a crime.
Yeah.
Ever since the dawn of time, if anything, everybody had the right to howl at the moon and to move all night. When folks would travel back before the Bible, they were liable to dance when the crops came in, or to pull all the stops when the earth would spin. Or maybe they had a battle to win, so they would dance. Every time they had the chance, no matter the reason or circumstance, they found a reason to throw a party in their pants. So let's do like they did, dance.
Party in your pants.
Yeah, now, friends, we're not saying the speech is bad. It's just that it's open.
Then what am I supposed to say? I've rewritten it 9 times.
Here's the thing. You're going to be talking to Reverend Warren, some of the stubbornest people in town.
You already got plenty of people boiling mad.
Yeah, folks are picking sides, and they're not picking yours.
This thing's gotten wet. Maybe I ought to just give up.
Oh, man, we didn't mean to discourage you, little buddy.
After all the posters we made, for all the flyers we handed out, people at school are climbing the walls.
You just gotta rethink your approach, so hang in there. Now, Mama says, everything I ever learned that gets me through the worst, I learned at my mama's knee.
Can't back down. Once you drive up a
enough trouble tonight. I don't want to cause any more. Chuck's been on a little tear ever since we found out about our little field trip to the barbecue dance house. He told me not to see you anymore, and I told him I'd see who I like, and he just started swinging.
Let me look at that eye.
Just so mad at myself, I don't know why I was with him in the first place.
Maybe you should see a doctor.
I'm fine.
You want me to call your folks?
No, I just want to be alone, okay?
Let's go back. Come on.
Would you like some company?
No. Yes.
Are you sure? I wouldn't take it personal if you...
Oh,
and disturbances will not be tolerated. Now let's open the floor for you.
Yes?
I'm Rin McCormick, and on behalf of most of the senior high class at Beaumont High, I'd like to move that Local Ordinance 416, the law against public dancing, be abolished.
And I will agree with Creative by Banana Ram Boulevard. I'd like to second that motion. Thank you.
Eleanor, may I have the floor?
Certainly,
Mr. McCormick, you wish to throw a dance and change our law, and that is your right. But it is my duty to challenge any enterprise which, in my experience, promotes the use of drugs, the abuse of alcohol, and most importantly, encourages spiritual corruption. And I think you'll find most people here agree with
you. You got that right.
Now, if any one of you can convince me there is no such danger in your raucous party plans, then perhaps I can reconsider it. But now, no. It just won't happen.
I believe the vote is in order.
Excuse me. Isn't there some kind of discussion or something?
That's outrageous! If you think...
Roger! Sit down. I think that Mr. McCormick has the right to be heard.
Thank you, Miss Moore. I just wanted to say a few things because I think the idea of a dance scares a lot of people, but it shouldn't. From the oldest of times, people dance for many reasons. They dance so that their crops will be good. They dance so their home will be plentiful. They dance to celebrate, and that's the dance we're talking about.
Mr. McCormick, we don't need a history lesson.
Excuse me, Reverend. Aren't we told in Psalms 149, praise ye the Lord, sing unto the Lord a new song, let them praise his name in the dance. And it was King David who we read about in Samuel. What did King David do? Here it is. King David danced before the Lord with all his might, leaping and dancing before the Lord, leaping and dancing. And Ecclesiastes assures us that there is a purpose and time for everything under heaven. A time to mourn, a time to laugh, a time to weep, and there is a time to dance. There is a time for this law, but no more. This is our time to celebrate. That's the way it was in the beginning, that's the way it always will be, and that's the way it should be now. Thank you.
Thank you.
Reverend.
Good evening, Crane. It's a bit late, don't you think?
Really? I hadn't even noticed. I have a question.
And it couldn't wait until the morning.
It's only one question. Before tonight's meeting, did you tell the council how to vote?
Well, Ren, we discussed the issue, of course.
But did you tell them how to vote?
This is more than an issue of dance.
Did you? I understand what this town has been through.
No. No, you don't. Because if you had, you and your classmates wouldn't have reopened the wounds we healed.
Those wounds aren't healed. If they were, people wouldn't be glaring at me on the sidewalks. They wouldn't be stabbing my mom at the supermarket. They wouldn't be boycotting my uncle's business. And you wouldn't be fixing the town council votes.
I thought it was time to put an end to this nonsense.
Nonsense? All I say is, who's up for a little dancing? And all the people in this town think about the four kids in the Tanya Bridge.
Master.
And I know that your son was one of them. And I'm sorry. I truly am. But honoring his memory by shutting up the world isn't working.
And I assume you have all the answers.
No, I don't
and
have...
And you're going to set me straight.
No, I didn't say that.
Mr. McCormick, how can you even presume to know what we've been through when you don't? Good night, Mr. McCormick.
Please, sir, if I could only just...
I would like to be alone.
Sir, you already are. We both are. You and me. I bet you stop 100 times a day and wonder why. I know I do. I wonder why my dad would leave. Was it something I did? Something I didn't do? Could I have made him stay? Could I bring him back? But I can't. But I don't need to tell you. You already know.
I do.
I guess I came to town a little fired up and mad, and it felt real good to kick up a fuss. And I know it upset a lot of people. And I'm sorry. I'm tired of looking back. I have to move forward, and I can't stand still.
I've noticed.
Well, I'm gonna go. And I understand that you have to do whatever you have to do about the dancing and the town council. But thanks for listening.
Ren, I'm sorry your father will never get to know you.
Thank you, sir.
Daddy?
Oh! Hi, Ariel.
I heard voices.
Yes, that was your friend, Ren. He sure asked a lot of questions.
What did you tell him?
Well, once, Ariel, I had very little to say. I think I'm running out of answers.
Daddy? I know it's hard for you, and I know I don't make it any easier. It's just that I don't know if I believe in all the things that you believe in. But I believe in you. Now, get some rest. You have a sermon in the morning.
If I can figure out what to say.
You will.
Come to me for protection. I guide them whatever the cost. But while I've been giving direction, maybe it's me who got lost. Heaven help me find my way now. Open up my heart again. Help me find the words to say now. Heaven, help me. Thank you.
I stand before you this morning, a changed man. You see, friends, it's my job as your preacher to help you find the joy in life. But last night, I realized I hadn't been doing that. After all, each and every one of us here remember that awful night 5 years ago, when four of Beaumont's brightest children lost their lives in the Botany Bridge accident. Everyone here lost someone. A child, a friend, a neighbor. Vi and I, we lost our son. Ariel lost her brother. Now somehow I got it in my mind that my loss was the greatest. And I allowed that burden to weigh me down as surely as a great stone. But last night, I did something I haven't done in a very long time. All because of one young man. Last night I laid down my burden. It was exhilarating and frightening at the same time. And today, friends, I invite you to that same opportunity. As many of you know, the senior class of Beaumont High wished to change our law and throw a dance. Ren, I think that might be a good idea. Please join me now in asking our Lord to guide and to protect our children.
Teach me where to start. Can you find